Unleashing your vocabulary. Idiomatic expressions in academic writing. Hello, learners. Today, we are going to focus on a particular idiom often used in academic and professional writing. You've likely seen it or heard it before, but do you know how to use it in your own writing? The phrase is, "It stands to reason that." So, buckle up as we deep dive into understanding and using this idiom effectively. "It stands to reason that" is an idiom we use when we want to say something is logical, sensible, or can be reasonably expected. This idiom is very handy when you want to express an opinion that is based on a logical conclusion or inference from the facts or evidence at hand. For example, if you are writing a research paper on the effects of regular exercise, you could write, "It stands to reason that regular exercise can improve overall health." This statement suggests that it's logical to conclude that exercise can improve health, based on the information you've presented or that is generally known. Now that you know what "it stands to reason that" means, let's explore how you can use it to craft sentences. When using this idiom, follow it with a clause, a part of a sentence that includes a subject and a verb. The clause should express the logical conclusion or reasonable assumption you're making. Here are a few more examples. 1. After observing the company's steady growth over the years, it stands to reason that their innovative strategies are effective. 2. Given the increasing global temperatures, it stands to reason that climate change is a pressing issue. 3. With his vast experience and knowledge in the field, it stands to reason that he would be an excellent candidate for the position. Remember, it's not a question, but a way of making an assertive statement based on evidence or observable facts. While "it stands to reason that" is a useful idiom, it's important to know when to use it versus other expressions. This idiom conveys a logical conclusion or inference, so it's not suitable for expressing personal opinions or beliefs that aren't based on fact. For instance, instead of saying, "It stands to reason that vanilla is the best ice cream flavor," you might say, "In my opinion, vanilla is the best ice cream flavor." The first sentence implies there's a logical basis for claiming vanilla as the best flavor, whereas the second acknowledges it as a personal preference. And that's a wrap on our lesson about the idiom, "It stands to reason that." By now, you should be more comfortable understanding and using this phrase in your academic or professional writing. It's a great tool to have in your language arsenal, and using it correctly can add credibility to your arguments. Remember, language is an art, and the more colors, or idioms, you have on your palette, the more vividly you can paint your thoughts. Until our next lesson, keep practicing and happy writing.